What's up guys, Bungie recently disabled the Vesper Radius, which was used in my previous Warlock build, and I know a lot of people were starting to use that, and now that it is disabled and we can't use it anymore, I decided to make another build for you guys to use in the meantime. Instead of being on Stasis, this one will be on Voidwalker on Devourer, which is one of my all-time favorite subclasses in Destiny. Then also we'll be using the Necrotic Grip, which is, in my opinion, the coolest new exotic armor piece, the CLC. And before we get into the video, today's the last day that my code Air is going to be 30% off for cheap fuel. If you ever want to support me more than just watching my videos, this will be the best way. So go ahead and try out some new flavors or stock up on your favorites. Click the link in the comments and description, and it'll take you straight to their store and apply my code for you. So let's go ahead and begin with the video. So this will start with the Necrotic Grip. Damaging combatants with melee attacks corrupts them with increasing damage over time. Defeating a corrupted combatant spreads the corrupting effect to nearby targets and restores melee energy. So whenever you melee a target with this exotic on, you'll poison them, and that poison will do more and more damage over time, and pretty much it works like Anarchy, but it gets higher and higher damage, and over the entire tick of the poison, you pretty much do like two, almost three shotgun shots worth of damage just from a single melee. And the thing that makes this absolutely insane in PvE is the fact that whenever an enemy dies that has been poisoned, it will spread to nearby targets, so pretty much one melee can do like three shotgun shots worth of damage to an entire room just from a single melee. So it pretty much goes without saying that this exotic is insanely top tier for PvE. Then if you pair that with bottom tree Voidwalker, which is Devourer, you'll have pretty much infinite health and infinite grenades just from a single melee. As you see in this clip, as long as there's enough enemies around and the poison keeps spreading, I mean, you rarely see Devourer go below 9 seconds. So you're constantly getting full health back, constantly getting 1/6 of a grenade depending on what your discipline stat is. Yeah, I mean, just from a melee alone, you're killing everything and you can't die. Devourer plus this exotic is already crazy and an insane build as is. Then we pair that with the 7 Seraph Carbine, which is the AR, and preferably you want Swashbuckler on it. And if you don't have this weapon, you can still get it from roll drops or farming the gunsmith packages, but you can really use any primary with Swashbuckler if you don't have this. Then in the secondary slot, you're going to want either the Akelos or Seraph Shotgun, both of which can come with Trench Barrel, and I don't have either of them with Trench Barrel in my account, which is kind of crazy because I played the crap out of the dungeon last season, which will be coming back tomorrow. So if you don't have this weapon, you can farm it in the dungeon starting tomorrow again. And just like the other Seraph weapon, you can get that from roll drops. But overall, the point of these two weapons is you're gonna be meleeing all the time. So with the Carbine, you're gonna be proccing Swashbuckler x5, which will make it extremely good and have the full damage perk at pretty much all times. And you use that to create more mind cells, and you just go around constantly meleeing and constantly gaining Swashbuckler x5. And the same thing with the shotgun. Whenever you get up to a Major and Ultra, you can punch them to poison them and also proc Trench Barrel, and you'll easily kill them and create even more Warmind Cells. So the mods we're using to create Warmind Cells are Global Reach to increase the radius of the explosion. Then another one we're using on top of that is Rage of the Warmind, which will make all the explosions slower damage. And you can pretty much use whatever you want in this slot. So by the end of the build, if you don't see a mod that you would normally use, you can go ahead and slot it here instead of this one. Then another mod we'll be using on this build is Heavy Handed, mostly for the second part. While surrounded by multiple combatants, defeating a combatant with a fusion rifle, shotgun, sidearm, or SMG adds ammo from the weapon to your reserves. So pretty much how this works is with either the Akelos or Seraph Shotgun, as long as you're surrounded by three or more enemies and you're not really spamming, you'll always get the ammo back to the reserves and pretty much have infinite ammo, which means you can kill all the Majors, all the Ultras, and create even more Warmind Cells. Then our exotic heavy of choice will be the Lament. You can pretty much use whatever exotic heavy you need for whatever you're doing. If you're doing a raid, you could use Xenophage. If you're doing strikes, Lament, you know, whatever. It's pretty much open slot. Then the final two mods are going to be Charge Harvester. That way when we're doing pretty much anything, getting kills with poison, grenades, whatever it is, we become charged with light. And with that stack, if you're using Lament, we're using Lucent Blade for that 35% more damage, and also the quicker energy recharge rate, which means we can use the chainsaw part of the sword more often. So overall, with the entire build, all the mods, all the perks, pretty much what you do is you just go around meleeing everything, and if you're using the Swashbuckler Carbine, that'll give you x5, which means you can create Warmind Cells very easily and have the full 33% buff pretty much at all times. Then for any Majors, you can punch them to poison them, then use the shotgun with Trench Barrel to finish them off and create even more Warmind Cells like that. So between the poison, devour, and having either Trench Barrel or Swashbuckler full perk at all times, I mean, red bars and Majors don't stand a chance. Like, you constantly have health, you'd have to try to die with this build. You're constantly getting full health back with devour, and devour isn't like a chunk, it's your entire health bar back instantly. So like, even if you take damage during it, it can't stop it. It's not like recovery. It's your entire health instantly back. And that's happening like 4 times a second with this build if you're poisoning everything in the room. On top of that, you're creating warmind cells to clear out the entire room pretty much in one shot. So yeah, frag clear, this build is absolutely crazy. Then when you get up to a major, you have the full 35% buff for your lament, which means you're pretty much gonna run through almost every boss in the game also. So this build is all around really good for pretty much anything you throw at it. And in the future seasons, if there is a season with Oppressive Darkness, again, like there has been pretty much once a year, this might be one of my go-to builds during that season. It's already insanely good, but imagine with infinite Oppressive Darkness grenades, you give yourself a full 35% buff and 30% debuff for your lament. So you're pretty much a one-man army at that point, have really good accuracy, really good boss damage. I mean, the build would pretty much check every single box possible in the game. Infinite health, infinite abilities, insanely good accuracy in multiple different ways, and really good boss damage. This is definitely one of those full-round builds that's just good for everything. Anyways, I think that's gonna be it for the video. My internet has been out the past few days. It should be getting fixed tomorrow. So yeah, I've been making these past few videos on mobile hotspots, which has been pretty interesting to say the least. Whenever I use stasis on my hotspot, sometimes they just don't get frozen, sometimes they just like teleport around. It's pretty funny to watch. But anyways, we've made the best of the situation and still got our videos out for the day. Outside of making videos, we pretty much can't play right now, so hopefully there's not anything too important tomorrow reset, because that is when they should be fixing my internet. But depending on when my internet's back will kind of determine what uploads come out when. I have a few like emergency videos to post just in case if like I literally can't connect at all for an entire day. So I'm sure I won't miss any days, but just giving you guys a heads up if there is a missed upload at some point. And anyways, make sure to use my code Ehroar on G Fuel for 30% off. Today's the last day. There will be more times in December that it's gonna be 30% off. So if you're like waiting to get paid or something like that, don't stress about it. There's gonna be more opportunities in December. And anyways, I wanna say thank you to all the people that have used my code. You guys have been popping off and you guys have gotten my G Fuel partnership off to a really, really good start. So let's try to keep it up. And yeah, that's me for the video. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys next time.